What is the way of escape? The battle with Amalek was won by Moses with upraised hands. Joshua and the army could not win by physical means. They needed God's intervention. If you read closely, you see the real battle was waged on the mountaintop. Moses was fighting and winning the battle as he sought the Lord through prayer. When Moses' hands dropped, the battle would turn against Israel. Without Moses and his upraised hands seeking God's power, Israel would have been defeated. I hope that sticks in your mind. Because Amalek is portrayed in the scripture as a picture of our battle with the flesh. And if we think by human means, by resolutions and resolves and trying harder and learning another verse and praying a little bit more, that somehow we are going to overcome our flesh, without the upraised hands seeking God's grace, God's favor, God's power, then we will live in defeat. The critical lesson for us is only the Spirit of God can defeat our flesh. We will win daily battles with temptations of our flesh by walking in the Spirit. When we go our own way, we face Amalek, our flesh, and we're defeated. And as Paul said, the defeat of our flesh comes only through the victory Christ already won for us on the cross. He brought us step by step to defeat our flesh in the power of the Spirit, as we believe the truth of the Spirit by God's power. God's word clearly warns us we do not conquer flesh by physical means. Asceticism, religious activity, human effort, no. It's only the power of the cross. And that's what we celebrate this morning. And I want you to turn with me where we're going to begin this evening, to Colossians chapter 3. And this is what I want you to think about as we prepare our hearts. Colossians 3, and starting in verse 5, because we are celebrating this morning the cross of Jesus Christ. And the cross of Jesus Christ is that Jesus Christ accomplished everything that needs to be done, first of all, to get me to heaven. Secondly, to defeat the flesh that I'm going to have with me till my last heartbeat and my last brainwave on this earth. And so are you, by the way. And like Amalek, it's always going to be coming on our weak backside and always sniping at us and cowardly attacking us. So what do we do about it? Look at Colossians 3. Because Amalek was their foe, but the flesh is our foe. And it says in Colossians 3:5, therefore consider the members of your earthly bodies as dead to immorality, impurity, passion, evil desire, greed, which amounts to idolatry. The Amaleks are an apt illustration of the sin that remains in our lives as believers. That sin is already utterly defeated, but has to be dealt with, not in our own strength. I don't defeat the lusts of my flesh myself, in my human cunning, thinking, I've got a new idea, this is how I'll do it. I defeat it solely through coming to Christ, who has already not only paid the price for all my sin, but has said, I have given you a victory that is a victory indeed in me. By faith, I have defeated. I can put to death that in your life if you will walk submitting to me. Communion is when you say, I submit. I trust in your power, O Christ. You have cleansed me. I can do nothing to achieve my standing with you, but I can choose by your grace to please you by obedience. That's what we do this morning.